Yo, welcome back to the channel, everyone. And in this video, we're gonna be going over the new best settings to use here in Black Ops Cold War Season 6. Now, if you guys are trying to drastically improve your aim, accuracy, and gun skill for this final season, I want you guys to take these settings into account and try them out immediately. So, with that being said, the like goal on this video has to be 1,000 likes. If we can get 1,000 likes in under 24 hours, that'd be absolutely incredible. Let me know down in the comment section right now, what are your current sensitivity settings you guys are running here in Black Ops Cold War? I think my settings will surprise you. Let's go over them right now. So as you guys can see here, I play with an Xbox Elite controller on PC. These settings are gonna work whether you guys are playing on an Xbox controller, a PS4 controller, or playing with a mouse and keyboard, doesn't really matter. Now, you guys can see here, my horizontal stick sensitivity as well as my vertical stick sensitivity are gonna be a 3. Yes, you see this correctly. I play on a 3-3 sensitivity. All the gameplays you guys saw on my channel are with a 3-3 sensitivity. Actually, I even bumped it down. I used to play on a 4-4, now I play on a 3-3 because I prioritize aim and accuracy when I play this game. Now, the reason I play on a low sensitivity is because this is a boots on the ground Call of Duty. Well, all your gunfights are going to be in front of you, to the right, or to your left. There is no need to be able to spin 360 degrees or 180 on this game because with the right map awareness, and honestly, just because it's a boots on the ground game, everything is going to be within your peripheral vision. And with the 3-3 sensitivity, you could snap on the players accurately and fast enough that you don't need to go ahead and play on a high sensitivity. Now, if you guys are struggling with trying to improve your aim and accuracy over ranges, because that's where I feel like a lot of players fall suit, definitely bump down your sensitivity to a 3-3 or at least a 4-4 to give it a try. You guys will see an immediate, and I mean an immediate increase in the shots you hit on target. Now, in order to kind of help this out, my low and my high zoom is also bumped down from a 1 to a 0.7. This works flawlessly with a 3-3 sensitivity because you're going to be able to accurately control your shots at those longer ranges, and that's where, again, a lot of players are going to fall short when playing Black Ops Cold War or any Call of Duty for that matter. So definitely go ahead and try out a 4-4 or a 3-3 with that 0.7 low and high zoom. I ran this during Modern Warfare, and I'm running it again during Black Ops Cold War, and I'm gonna run it again during Vanguard because it works game after game after game. Now, for the button layout, I highly recommend you guys, whether you guys are playing with an Xbox Elite, a SCUF, or a regular controller, play on the tactical button layout. There's absolutely no reason as to why players are not playing on the tactical button layout. It's going to remap your crouch and your prone button from the B button to pressing down on that right thumbstick, so you guys can get in and out of cover a lot quicker, in turn staying alive a lot longer, and also you can drop shot a lot easier because you do not have to take your thumb off of your thumbstick, so you guys can maintain your aim and accuracy while drop shotting. That's exactly why I run the airborne elastic wrap on all of my class setups, because I'm utilizing the tactical button layout, which is, in my opinion, the best button layout no matter what Call of Duty game you guys are playing. Now, everything else is going to be pretty much the same. My aim response curve type is going to be set on linear. I like to go ahead and run this because it's going to kind of closely mock and also kind of complement running that 3-3.7 with that tactical button layout. This allows us to have aim stick maps directly to aim rate. The aim stick curve is the same as the aim rate, so everything is going to be streamlined and the same, and that's kind of what I like. Consistency. I'm being consistent in my accuracy because I play on a low sensitivity, a high zoom, and also I'm playing on that button layout, so everything is going to work out flawlessly and it's going to complement each other. So definitely go ahead and run that. Now, everything else is going to be kind of disabled and also the same across the board. Now, you guys might see this is something that I always kind of mention. My controller vibration is going to be disabled. This is a setting that you're either going to turn off and never turn back on, or turn it off and just turn it back on. Honestly, I don't like playing with controller vibration. It messes up my aim and accuracy. I don't want to have my controller shaking. So if you guys are struggling with taking people out at longer ranges, definitely go ahead and turn this off. I think you guys will definitely improve your aim and accuracy over ranges by doing so. Now again, everything else is going to be pretty much the same. I have not messed with my aim assist mode because honestly, it could be thrown off from Call of Duty to Call of Duty, and the worst thing you want to have happen is having to relearn how to actually shoot. So definitely just keep everything the same, and I think all the other settings are pretty straight across the board. The most important thing is going to be definitely reducing your sensitivity down to either a 4-4 or a 3-3, and also going ahead and reducing your low and high zoom to a 0.7, and then running that tactical button layout so everything is going to be kind of streamlined. You don't have to take your thumbs off your buttons in order to drop shot. Definitely a good idea when playing a first-person shooter, especially Call of Duty. Now we're going to go over and touch up with the audio settings, which I feel like a lot of people overlook and they don't really think is that important. Now I play with an Astro A40 TR headset, so I can hear footsteps loud as day coming from a mile away. And honestly, that's exactly why they call me ears. Now for my headset settings, you guys are going to see here, everything is going to be pretty much the same. I've just reduced the music volume slightly, but you guys can see here my audio preset is going to be set to boost high. This is going to allow me to actually pinpoint gunfire across the map, and most importantly, pinpoint footsteps, so I know where people are at. And especially if they do not have on Ninja, it's a wrap. I can hear them coming a mile away, and I can pre-aim and be ready to pre-fire anybody coming around the corner that is not running Ninja. So definitely go ahead and slap on high boost. And even if you do not have an Astro T40 headset, maybe running a regular headset or surround sound, you can still hear footsteps and pinpoint audio with that boost high setting. So definitely go ahead and run this if you guys are playing Black Ops Cold War. Now everything else is going to be pretty much the same. I have not messed with any of these settings. The most important thing is going to be going ahead and putting on this high boost setting. Now for the graphics, this is going to kind of represent what type of monitor you have. I play with an Asus TUF gaming monitor, so I am running at 120 hertz refresh rate, and again, everything else is going to be pretty much the same. Now my field of view is going to be set to 120. I recommend you guys playing on 120 FOV when playing Call of Duty. It allows you to have a larger field of view, and also I kind of feel that it, for me personally, I am more accurate and I have a better control over my character with a higher FOV. Something that I recommend you guys all turning up, and I think a lot of us have been begging for an FOV slider, so since we have this option available, utilize it. And because we have an 120 FOV, we're going to run on the ADS field of view as affected. Now the affected ADS field of view is going to represent the iron sights, your red dot, to depending on what field of view you're playing. So this is going to, in a way, remove all of the visceral recoil you guys have in game, because it's going to represent that FOV you have. So there's no reason to go ahead and have this as independent, because it's going to just completely throw off the whole point of running a 120 FOV. You're going to utilize that higher FOV with that kind of represented ADS field of view. So definitely go ahead and make this adjustment. And that's going to be it. These are going to be the settings you guys definitely want to go ahead and check out if you guys are playing Black Ops Cold War and you guys are really trying to improve your aim, accuracy, and gun skill in this game for Season 6. Again, everything is going to be the same. It's going to be dependent on your PC, but for the most part, it's going to be streamlined across the board. Now again, if there is one thing you guys can take away from this video, bump down your sensitivity, run a 3-3.7.7 with the tactical button layout with that linear aim assist response curve, and come back to this video and let me know how you guys improve. I can guarantee you a lot of you guys who are struggling with taking enemies out at medium to longer ranges are going to have a drastic increase on how many shots you get on target and how many people you start outgunning. Hope you guys do enjoy this video. Hope it does help you guys out. And if it did, make sure you guys drop a like on the video, subscribe to the channel, and also turn on those post notifications. And do not forget, about 70% of you guys who are watching the content each and every day are not yet subscribed. So click the notification bell and become part of the year's family. I'm going to catch you guys in the next one. Deuces.